First of all, quiero darle gracias a Dios por brindarme la oportunidad de estar con ustedes y el público que nos esté escuchando. Lo siento un poco porque, como ustedes saben, mi compañera de las tesoros, que es Beatriz, está un poco malita y no puede estar con nosotras. So, de parte de ella, quiero entregarles todo su corazón, todos sus recuerdos y manténganla en oración.
You know, I've always told everybody that I wish she would have been, because, oh my goodness, I can just imagine Rita. You know how proud Beatrice and I and you girls are because of the nomination that we got from Washington, D.C. You know how proud she would have been. And it really hurts me that she wasn't with us, but the Lord needed her. So, and it's been a year and a half almost that she's gone. It's rough, it's been kind of rough. First of all, we met all the other participants. There was 9 besides Beatrice and myself, of different countries, of different awards, of different kinds of their type of work. So it was very interesting. And of course, to be able to, we performed at the, what is it? The Library of Congress. It was very, very beautiful. And again, I want to thank Graciela, all her staff, and of course, San Antonio too, for sending us to Washington for this. I understand it was the highest award in the entertainment world for entertainers. Well, I think it was just a whole big family all together, because it was Graciela's administrative La Esperanza and all her people that work with her, you know, under her, yourself, and Susana, I think, was there, Amy. Just a big family from Esperanza going, traveling, you know, because I don't think none of us, I mean, the mariachi and ourselves, we hadn't been to Washington, D.C.
Morir nací. Amigos, les contaré. Una acción muy popular. Ese me enseñó a olvidar. No más un orgullo tengo, ya nadie le sé rogar.
¡Aguántale, chaparrita!
This is the one from San Antonio. See how bright and shiny it is? See how this is the one from Washington, D.C. See the difference of the size? Well, I'm telling you, of course, I shouldn't say this. I'm very proud to have received this. But to me, this is from our city, from where I live, where I was born. So they both mean a lot, but this is kind of more interesting. You understand what I'm trying to say? I'm not putting down Washington. It's the thing that this is from San Antonio, Texas, the place where I was born, where I was raised. This is my barrio. I went right here across the street in J.T. Breckenridge, number 21. That's where I went to elementary school. I grew up very happy. I had a beautiful childhood here. Everything you girls, the functions you have here is beautiful. Because I'm very proud because to see the people from the neighborhood come and be with you guys. And then, you know, like when you make that parade, and it's something beautiful, something to see, you know, something del barrio, que la gente le gusta. Como Beatriz out of the tesoros, it was 4 of us, like you know. Of course, the first that passed away era Perla Tapatía Jenelle Cortez. She was the only female singer in the state of Texas and probably in the United States, like I've always said, that could sing with a tracheotomy in her throat. I think the only one from Mexico is Beatriz. But she was raised here since she was like 12 or 13. So we tell her she's from San Antonio already. And Perla, I think she lived, I don't know, somewhere way over years back. You girls weren't even born. Rita, well, she grew up, I think she said, on 19th Street over here. So this is an anecdota real pretty that a little lady, more abuelita than Rita and Beatrice and myself, comes to us and hugs Rita, hugs me, and hugs Beatrice.
And then she says, oh, I'm so glad to see you, okay, all this kind of stuff. And then she hugs Rita and tells her, but Rita, since you're the oldest one, no quiero que te enojes. Dijo, because of what I'm going to tell you. So she grabs like this all three of us, because era una abuelita chiquita, y dice, pero yo creo que se habían muerto ya. but then, you know, little things like this, because people think that, well, you know, Beatrice is the youngest. Right now, she's 84, I think, apenas. And Rita would get after me because I would say, 95-year-old Rita Vidaurri. Blanquita, tengo 94, no 95. And I never did it on purpose, but for some reason I said 95 instead of 94. She always used to get after me because of that.
Con una traición igual. Para cuando te emborraches, tú sepas lo que es llorar.
I work on and off, not often, but not with all this virus stuff now, but before, normally with different groups of mariachis, and Beatrice does too, and probably Rita did too. Well, in my opinion, mija, because que siga la cultura, you know, the younger singers, the younger dancers, the younger musicians, to see us as elders, they're elders, and we're still hanging in there. So, you know, like all the youngsters, mariachis and cantantes and all that, para que siga la cultura de nosotros, que siga viva. And that's what Esperanza does. It, you know, it helps everybody in the entertainment world that wants to do something about it. Porque si no sigue, pues se les olvida. You know what I mean? The way you grew up, the area that you grew up. Like you know, girls, like I always say that I grew up here. And they say, Blanquita, why do you? It's because it's true. That's where I grew up. You know, at the Guadalupe Theater, at the Guadalupe Church. And it's, I feel it's very important for our children, our great-grandchildren, our grandchildren, not to forget, you know, how we were brought up. Of course, it's different, but still, we don't want them to forget. Well, I wish that, you know, all those young ladies that are trying to learn how to sing, or they sing already, they belong to mariachi groups, especially now that the high schools have, you know, the mariachi groups, to see us as an example. You know, and like, for example, they say, golly, Blanquita and Beatrice and Rita are still singing. You know, maybe we're going to get to sing as long, you know, to get as old as they are, and still be able to sing, you know. If they did it, and now that everything is easier for them, they have the classes at school. So I think it's more opportunities that we did not have.
Yo nunca te importé, jugaste con mi destino, pero recuerda mi bien, que lo que se hace, se paga. Y espero verte al final, llorando por una ingrata. Te vas a arrepentir de lo que hiciste conmigo. Yo no te quiero ver.
I was a coach. I coach in singing. See, you have to know how to sing when you come to me, because I teach you how to stand up straight, how to breathe correctly with your diaphragm, because if you don't breathe with your diaphragm, you can't make a long note. You chop your voice, you know, the key of this tone that you're singing. That's what I do, Mija. I coach in singing. I teach them how to do it correctly, in other words. Uh-huh. That's what I do. Uh-huh. And then the young people come to me and I show them how to do it. Never forget them. There are five mentors. The first one was Lidia Mendoza, Eva Garza, Esperanza Espino, Rita Vidaurri and Carmencita Rodriguez. And let me tell you, when I used to live over here at the courts at 412 Tulipán Place, that playground is between San Fernando and San Luis. And where I lived was a playground. And across the street where I lived Eva Garza's parents. That's how come I met Eva Garza. And she was married to El Charro Gil, but almost once a year, you know, to visit the mother. And that's where I met Eva Garza, and she knew that I was an amateur in singing and all of this, And behind me on San Luis vivía Lidia Mendoza. And after I took my first classes in the guitar with my father, Lidia Mendoza me quiso enseñar la guitarra doble que ella toca, pero es muy difícil, because you have to be pressing down two strings instead of one, like a regular guitar. Y me rajé, como lo dicen, pero sí me dio varias clases ella. Y Lidia Chica iba conmigo a Lanier. She was, I think, about a year or one or two behind me. Y también detrás de mí vivía, across the street from Lidia, vivía Lalito Stoll. He was a very famous radio announcer from KCOR. So a lot of us entertainers lived in this area, you know, that a lot of people don't know. I was an amateur at the Teatro Guadalupe, and the person that won first place, either Child or Ed or whoever was the first one, the prize was, aquí en San Antonio, you girls probably don't remember, but había un teatro como Vaudeville, que era el Zaragoza. Se presentaban las variedades. El Nacional era el teatro como era el Alameda. Y entonces, el first place era que allí te daban la oportunidad de estar toda una semana con las artistas que estuvieran actuando esa semana en el Teatro Zaragoza. And that's where I met all of them. Because thank God I got first place, I went to perform over there, and that's where I saw Eva Garza, Esperanza Espino, Rita Vidaurri, and Carmencita Rodriguez for the first time. And you know that my first traje de charro, my parents paid $15 to Rita, because Rita, when she would come from Mexico, ella traía sus trajes que le hacían en México y nos vendía a las principiantes. You know, and then when she returned to Mexico, pues claro, se hacía más trajes bonitos. Pero en ese tiempo, 1940, era mucho dinero, $15. My first charro traje.
Probablemente ya de mí te has olvidado, y mientras tanto yo te seguiré esperando. No me he querido ir para ver si algún día que tú pienses volver me encuentres todavía. Por eso aún estoy en el lugar de siempre, en la misma ciudad y con mi misma gente, para que tú al volver no encuentres.
Tu papá no quería que fueras ni bailarina, ni cantante, ni nada, because you would be the black sheep of the family. You know, querían que fueras a la escuela, que te casaras, que tuvieras familia, this type of, que tuvieras tu casa. No, si te gustaba bailar o cantar o tocar algún instrumento, forget it. You know, you were no good. ¿Ves? Pero no, yo animo a todo muchacha, tanto muchacha como muchacho, que si les gusta la música, estudien. Eso es muy importante, mija, because you might be out of practice, but you never forget. Aunque hay muchos músicos que son, como decíamos nosotros, de oreja, que te tocan lo que te toca a un lector, pero es mejor si conoces. Digamos, por tu bien, vaya. Try to explain it to Beatriz, como ella no conoce nuestro, ¿cómo te puedo decir? Our heritage, de aquí, you know what I'm saying, the way we grew up. Porque como te digo, ella vino de México para acá, chiquita, de 12, 13 años. So I try to explain to her how the importance for us to have him, especially de aquí de San Antonio, to have gotten that award. Por eso digo, si viviera Rita, cuando nosotros recibimos este, no hombre, cállate. Forget it, you girls knew her already, you know how, forget it, you know how she was. Graciela got us four together. Rita always used to tell us before Perlita passed, ya que la Esperanza nos reunió y nos hizo las tesoros, vamos, y todo el tiempo dice, yo las voy a echar por delante, en paz descanse, you know, yo las voy a echar a ustedes por delante. And we actually, all four of us, since she was the elder, you know, I thought of it that way too, you know, but we never know when it's our time to go with the Lord, you know. And like I said, first it was esta Perla, y luego esta niña Rita, y luego pues no sabemos ahora de Beatriz y yo. Hay gente que es increíble, but everywhere we perform, at least one person, an older person like myself, remembers one of us, ¿verdad, Graciela? One of us, either Beatriz or Rita or myself. So we want the younger people to just study, you know, and continue. Don't give it up. Don't give it up, like I said. Yo voy a ser la última, voy a cantar y decir, ¡ah, cuácala! Voy a soltar en el foro. Because we always used to say, I've always said that too, because like you said, I come from a musical family that I want to sing the last note and then fall on the stage. And that's the way Rita would always tell us. And she said, you girls better promise me that all four of us, since we're together, we don't know who's going to go first. But we're going to go, like she always said, you girls know that. She always said she was going to be the last one to go. She was going to send Beatriz, Perla, and myself, and she was going to be the last one of the tesoros to last. Yes, and I just want to ask everybody to keep us in prayer, porque you know que todas somos grandes, Beatriz y yo, y pues hemos estado malitas, y uno nunca sabe lo que puede pasar. Y quiero yo, estoy muy agradecida con todo San Antonio, todo con ustedes principalmente, que nos llevaron a Washington, a Denver, todos los lugares donde nos han traído. Creo yo que yo quiero terminar, como decía Rita, hasta que quede el último tesoro. No se van a rajar. Si yo me voy primero, no se van a rajar. And that's what I want to do. Or like I said, when I find out, when I feel that I can't do it no more, well, I'll say, I'm sorry, you know, I can't do it anymore. So, okay, you're welcome. God bless.
Cantarle alegría a esta tierra tejana. Yo le canto a las misiones y a mi catedral hermosa y al lindo paseo del río, orgullo de mis paisanos. Que me traigan aquí
a la catedral.